5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let us start learning how to make countdown timer in Adobe Premiere. Open the Adobe Premiere and start with a new file. Click this new item icon and select title option. Name it as circle. Now go to the title tools section and select the ellipse tool. Press the shift key and draw a circle in the middle of the screen. Open the title properties now. Deselect the option fill. Select inner stroke. Let's change its value to 60. You can change its color using this color palette as well. Let us now go back to timeline and add circle to the timeline. Enlarge it a little and set its duration to 5 seconds. Now go to the effects panel and search for wipe. You can either double click or drag and drop this option radial wipe on element circle. In the effects control panel, click this circle near transition option to add a keyframe. Drag this keyframe to the extreme left. Click this keyframe dot to add one more keyframe and drag it to the extreme right. Move this header now to the extreme left to make sure that the value of transition option is 0. Then move it to the extreme right and change its value to 100. That's it. The basic timer is complete. Let's go back to new item and select the option transparent video. Drag and drop this element to main timeline. Make sure its duration is same as that of circle. Search for timecode effect. Either double click or drag and drop it on the element. You can see this timer is added on the screen. Let's change its size according to our requirement. You can change the opacity of background color as well. Place it where you want it to be in your video. There are options to change the format as well. Pick the time display as per your file settings. Also, you can set the starting offset of your timer. Let's now search for another effect, crop. Double click it to add to the effect controls panel. Using left and right options, you can crop the part that you do not need for your project. If you want to add drop shadow, search for it in the effects panel and select the drop shadow effect. You can see a drop shadow added and you can change it as per your need. If you want to change the color of the timer, search for tint effect and add it as well. Open this color palette and set the color that you want. You can see that the timer is starting from 0, but we need it to be a countdown timer. So right click this element and select the option nest. Right click this element again and select the option speed/duration. Select the option reverse speed on this dialog box and click OK. You can see that the timer works fine now, except we have 0, 0 displayed as the last second. To fix this, double click this nested sequence and increase the duration of the element by 1 second. Go back to main timeline and that's it. Your timer is all fine. Now let's try to move the circle to somewhere else. Let's quickly adjust the timer as well. Let us check it. Seems like there is an issue with the wipe effect. Lock this top layer and double click the circle in preview window. You will see that the anchor point is not in the middle of the circle. It's very easy to fix. Here are the X and Y positions of the circle. Let's change those to more readable values, 570 and 650. Now go to the effects panel and change the X and Y positions here to 570 and 650. make the same change to the anchor point as well. And make the same change to the vibe center as well. That's it. Your timer has been moved to a new location and is working all fine. Let's now make a duplicate copy of the circle element. Let's quickly move it to the right. There are some rendering issues with the timer that we can ignore. I have quickly changed its anchor and vibe center values so that it should work properly. Yes, it seems all fine. Let us now go to the Finder window and import a PNG file in the project. Drag and drop the image on the main timeline and make sure its duration is same as that of the circle. Let's quickly adjust its position and size to place it in the middle of the circle. Go to the Effect panel and add the radial vibe to this image as well. Add a keyframe to the transition option and drag it to the extreme left. Add one more keyframe and drag it to the extreme right. Drag the header to the extreme left and make sure that the transition value is 0. Then drag the header to the extreme right and set its value to 100. So now you have another style of timer ready to be used. You can choose it to be clockwise, anti-clockwise, or both sides as per your requirement. That's it from this video. Hope you enjoyed it.